Welcome back to another jam-packed episode of The Art of Doing Epic Coop Build. Today we're going to be building and installing a five-box nesting box on this side of the coop. Stay with us. Welcome back, everybody, to The Art of Doing. We seek to inspire you to practice doing new and different things, explore new interests, and discover new passions. If this is the first time to the channel, I'd love for you to consider hitting that subscribe button and click that notification bell. We're constantly covering new and different topics, and you don't want to miss a thing. Today, we're going to be putting a nesting box on the Epic Coop build. This is going to be 5 feet long, 13-inch tall, sloped roof, drop-down doors, and a bunch of other tricks. Stay tuned. Okay, to get the exact dimensions of this nesting box, I'm going to go to the inside. The nesting box area has already been framed out. If you've seen the other episodes, and I'll leave a link to the playlist up above, you saw that this area is already framed out for this nesting box. I'm going to go inside the coop and drill out the four corners, and then use a jigsaw to cut out this panel. That'll give me the exact dimensions for the nesting box. And then I'll use this piece that I cut out for the front of the nesting box door. Waste not, want not. Somebody always said. Okay, it's cutting just a little bit into the 2x4. I'm gonna ride a little shy of the line. And even if I take off it, I mean, it's a hair of the 2x4. Cutting pretty difficult. It's my first time using a jigsaw, but I did feel like it was cutting a little rough. This is a fairly paper thin strip off the 2x4 that it's also cutting. I'll just come down a little bit. I'm not worried about the integrity. That's a double top plate on that 2x4, but that's why it was pulling a little rough. This is two sheets here, so I'm gonna stop here, cut over, and then take this piece off. Yep, hitting the 2x4 there a little bit. I wanted to do this from the inside looking out so I could see where the 2x4 was, but the longest blade I could find on the jigsaw was only 5-inch, and it sticks into the jigsaw a little bit, and obviously a 2x4 is 3.5-inch, so I had to do it from the outside. But to make life easier, I'm still gonna raise it up a little bit. Okay, I've got everything I need for the build of the frame of the coop. I've already cut all the lengths. I'll show you a little bit how I did that, but I didn't want to bore you with that. Got a level, my Kreg pocket hole jig, and I'll leave a link for a review and an unboxing I did of this. Drill and impact driver, digital angle finder. That'll come into play later. My rough hand-drawn sketch of how this is gonna go. Couple of pieces here. So I'll show you basically what we're gonna look to do, and then I'll build it out. This is going to sit away from the coop. This is going to sit right up against the edge of the coop. This is gonna sit just like this. Roof of the egg box will go here. This little piece goes right inside. And this is the rough side frame. Okay, that should be all the pocket square holes. Now let's start putting some of this together. There was one that I did a little earlier that separated while I was drilling it this way, but as it screwed in, it pulled it back together. I don't know. Let's see what we got. As an aside, when I built this table, I didn't film it. This was before my filming days. I wasn't doing much woodworking. I wish I had carried this tabletop out maybe 4 or 5 inches so I could clamp under the table. I'm kind of hanging out over here and having a counterbalance. So I wished I had done that differently, but that's already done. Let me talk about how I measured this. I just calculated how much this length I needed and how high I needed. But this cut and these couple of cuts were a little tricky for me. is, I went to go line this up. It just didn't line up. It was driving me crazy. If you saw my issues I had on my roof build of the coop, I was driving myself crazy. Not the roof, I'm sorry, the rafter build. I'll leave a link up above and down below for the playlist for the rest of the coop build. But I had such issues with my angles. I went and I got a digital angle finder, which is great. Hit the on button, slap it on an angle, and it reads out exactly what that angle is, and then you can go recreate it somewhere else. So I used this and I got beautiful angles, and something still came out wrong. I was doing a little panicking, but this piece is in the way. If I set it on these two pieces, it fits great. If I set it up here, that piece is in the way. I think I'm just gonna remove this piece. This will be plenty sturdy enough. So I'm gonna remove this piece and install these two pieces like that. The way I actually designed this angle is I just put a piece up on a couple of pieces of wood, decided how I liked it, and then took my level and drew a line. Then I took the angle finder and copied that angle for the upright and for the other pieces. For this piece, to find this angle, I finished these two angles and drew a straight line. It worked out. Let's remove this and then I'll finish installing. That'll fit a lot nicer. Okay, now we can put the clamps away, swap out this bit for some deck screw bits, and start the rest of the assembly. Okay, these back two pieces are what's gonna mount to the edge of the coop, to the front edge of the coop where the framing is. So I need to make sure this is the correct height. Just gonna measure that out. This board is a little warped. I'm gonna try to clamp it closed. That's a lot better. Beautiful. Okay, I think now I'm gonna work on building the door. The door is gonna swing down so that I can reach in, access the eggs. I don't wanna come in over the top and scare the birds. And I also don't wanna have the hinge up here and risk leaking down behind. It'll also be easier to clean out if the door drops down and I can just pull out any mess that's in there. Okay, time to bust out the pocket hole jig again. I'm gonna do pocket holes for the door. It'll make sense once I'm slapping it together. Okay, that's all the pocket holes. Now I can start squaring this off and screwing it together. Okay, so this is going to have hinges underneath here. I have it a little bit lower than this piece here, just in case the roof is coming down. When this folds out, I don't want it to knock on the top of the roof. Hopefully you can see that. And this is nice and recessed inside the profile of the egg box. This will cut down a little bit on draft. It's nice and tight. And then we're going to put locks on the tops. It took a couple minutes to pre-paint this. Much better. That's on tight. I'm shaking the whole coop. Okay, I'll put on some side pieces and I'll start working on the floor. The door is already painted. I just have to put those couple of pieces that I cut off on. Hinges, you'll see. I can't remember if I mentioned it, but these going into the sideways studs are 3.5-inch screws. I'm gonna use 1.25 inch for this siding into the 2x4. I'm gonna end up painting this white as well. Door is gonna drop down like this. Since I'm only going the short way on the 2x4, I really couldn't find too much in the way of hinges. So I'm gonna use two sets of piano hinges. They're kind of thin and flimsy, but because they're going the whole length of the door, I'm pretty confident that they're gonna be sturdy enough. Getting a little late in the day, I want to make sure I get this roof on to protect any weather coming in this open hole. So let me put that on now. Okay, before I continue, I got a couple of issues that I need to fix in this design. So for one, the bird blocking, I need to put a piece of wood up here. I've ripped down a piece of 2x4, the full length, and I cut it on an angle with a jigsaw, and man, did that take a long time. I need a table saw. And then the second issue is, so the door that we're gonna install has a 2x4 frame like this, and it's got the cladding inside to block this part. But what I didn't measure out is when this door comes up, because the cladding is tacked to the 2x4, it hits this back 2x4 and it doesn't go all the way in flush. What I should have done is take this 2x4 and turn it this way so that I had the clearance to get this underneath it. I thought I would be getting a nice seal and a nice airtight, not drafty seal by doing it like this. So what I'm gonna have to do is notch this 2x4 out enough to get this sheathing to sink into it so that the 2x4 on the frame of the door sinks flush. It's either that or take this whole thing off and redo it. And needless to say, these couple of design flaws, I'm not gonna be making furniture anytime soon. They're slowing me down a little bit, but it'll still come out something deadly. I'm also gonna put a block right up here to push up against the roof deck in the center as a rafter. I'm just gonna screw it into this 2x4 here. Here's that 2x4 that I ripped on an angle, just so it can wedge under here tightly. Let's put this in. Oh, that's perfect. Which deck screws? And then I'm just gonna push this up to this back point and sturdy this whole roof up. As usual, I'm sure it's overkill, but I wanna make this nice. It's a tough angle, I can't fit the drill in there. I'm gonna start these. Rock solid. Okay, now I have to work on notching out this 2x4 and this 2x4 so that the cladding sits flush. And I'll do that off camera. That's gonna take a little bit. This is probably not the best way to do it, but this is the tool I have that I figure can do the job. I can't get all the way to the edge. I'm gonna have to maybe use a oscillating saw, maybe a chisel. Basically, I just made the depth down to this line and adjusted the blade down to that depth. The depth I need this way, I marked the line, and then I just cut on that line. Wow, that was uncomfortable. And I ate a lot of sawdust on that one. I bet I'm wishing I designed this well in the first place. Yes, yes I am. Okay, let me set the depth for this one. So I'll do that on camera. I don't think I've done that on camera yet. So I unplugged the saw. Double check it, can't be too safe. So I'm just gonna set the blade against the wood. Actually, can you guys see this? so you can see this depth line here. And again, the saw is unplugged. Okay, so the blade depth bar is loose. I'll pull back the safety, put the blade right flush against the board I want to cut. And then I can raise this blade up just to the depth, just where the deepest tooth is, just where I want it. And then you lock that blade down. So now, when I plunge the saw in on my chalk line, it'll go right to the cut that I made. Let me cut this open. We'll go from there. Like I said, I can't get all the way to the edge with the circular saw, so we'll have to fix that. Let me make this cut up top, and then we'll work on joining these cuts. I just drew a line with a Sharpie on this blade. Hopefully that's enough of a guide. Having a hard time doing it left-handed here. I might have to chisel that out. And I'm also gonna repaint this to seal this. Ready to start a forest fire in here. That's pretty good. I'm gonna clean this up just a little bit with a little chisel, and then I will test the door to see if it fits, which is where I realized I made this mistake last time. Then we'll paint this up and get this door mounted finally. Let's see what we got. A little tight on this side, but I put it too high as well. And I always do this, I make my tolerances so tight. And there's a little something over here. I'm gonna look inside the coop and see if I can't see and mark what I need to trim. Okay, I trimmed up the door and I painted over some of the spots that I trimmed up. So while I'm waiting for that to dry, I'm gonna throw on the roof. Now this should be a lot easier than the last roof I did. I'll throw a link up above to the roof I did on the main structure. And of course I'll throw a link at the end and down in the description for the whole playlist for this whole coop build. But like I said, this should be a lot smoother and easier and quicker than the last roof. And we'll have a more in-depth view and close-up view of the whole job. So let's get at it. So first thing you do is drip edge on the eave side. This is gonna go under the tar paper. And this is so nice, it's so small, I don't even have to measure. I can just put it up and cut it. Okay. And just like the main roof, 1-inch galvanized nails, and I'm coming about a pinky. I don't have a fascia board here. I'm just gonna come a pinky off of this board. Hopefully I have enough, huh? Trim this right to the drip edge. These are 1-inch galvanized plastic washer, specially designed for underlayment nail. Okay, now we can throw shingles up. We're gonna do starter strips on the front edge and up the, I believe this is called the eaves, and then we'll do the shingles. Okay, this is so fun. Again, there's so little to do here. Pales in comparison to the big roof on top, but this is the starter strip. It's got a tar strip. It's gonna go right along the bottom edge, and that'll glue the bottom edge of the shingles down, because you don't nail this far down on the shingle. It'll stop the wind from lifting this up. And we're also gonna throw, of course, up the side for the same reason, because the shingle overhangs the drip edge a little bit. If you can see that, you can't put any nails into the drip edge, so this tar strip will hold that down from blow-offs. Same type of screw, same type of nails. And we're gonna go flush on this side and about a little less than a half an inch. Really doesn't matter how far you come off this edge, as long as it's consistent. Now, on the eave end, rake end, I called this eave end. On the rake end, you don't have to come all the way to the edge. You actually don't want to interrupt this strip. So you want to cut this a little before that strip, a couple inches. Okay, now for shingles. Okay, so now you can line this up square with the drip edges on both sides. And we want 6 nails in this nailing zone. I forgot on that, on the roof, I wanted to come really low on this nailing strip to nail down the top of the starter strip. And I forgot to do that, so I'm just gonna throw a couple in here. So, this course, we're gonna take 6 inches off of so that we have a staggered joint so that the edge of this tile, this shingle, doesn't meet up with the edge of this shingle. So it's overlapped some. So let me take that. I'm gonna have a flashing coming off of the deck here covering this, and I want it long enough to cover up this nailing strip. I made a mistake with this last time, so I wanna make sure I get it right. So I trimmed 6 inches off of this so that the edges don't overlap, and I trimmed the top off so that it covers the nail strip, but the flashing will still cover it. Let's keep our fingers crossed. Excellent. Now we just trim this edge off. Okay, now we have to just put the flashing on to seal the wall to the shingle. To get the flashing on, I'm gonna notch this siding all the way down. I'm gonna slide the flashing behind this siding and nail it down to the shingles. I don't know the best way to do this, but I'm gonna go back to my trusty circular saw and put it right against the decking and make a straight line. I've already marked that out, so here we go. A little notch off that. I'm gonna have to repaint that. Still gonna get this back this way, but I can't turn the saw over because this side is fatter. I don't want to trim this down just yet. I still have to inch it over that way. And I want to make sure I don't go too short. I've got it all the way to the edge. Got most of it in. Just got to slide more of it in. I want a lot more of it into the coop. Maybe another 3 inches. I might not get that wish of more into the coop. Not ready to trim this edge just yet. That took a lot longer than I was expecting. I've got the edge in there. I'm gonna try to pull it up some, and then I'll keep coming back and trimming this down. Really, if I can just get it in there even, I'll be happy, because this is a pain. Moving this like half an inch at a time. And I think I'm pretty even. I'm gonna measure it out, and if I'm even, that's as far as I'm gonna go. Need a half an inch on this side to be even. I think I pulled this side extra. Now the other side's short. I'm gonna do something crazy and pull this back a little. I'm gonna put a couple of screws on the inside to fasten this to the inside studs. Give it a little more pinch than just pushing this in. And then I'm gonna hammer this in to be flat. Okay, I think I'll lay some mastic under the flashing and then nail it down. And I'll silicone this seam. And I'll probably touch paint that up afterwards as well. Before I do that, I think I'm gonna throw this door on before I run out of light, make sure this fit is right. And before I do that, if this is giving you any value, if you're enjoying this video, or if you know anybody that may enjoy this video, why don't you hit that like button and send this off to them, share this with a friend. I appreciate it. fit is right. I still need to trim a little bit off this inside edge so it closes smoothly, but I'm gonna go ahead and install the hinges and get this on here permanently, throw on the locks and the handle. I'm gonna go with a pair of this type lock. Because this door is so long, I didn't want to just do one lock. Also, because it's so long, I didn't want to do the gate closure that automatically locks it when you push it closed. I've got a young son, and I wanted him to be able to do this so he can undo one side and then the other side. Oh, I also hit it with some hammered finish black spray paint to give it a little bit of finished look, and not all of the hardware that I bought was exactly matching finish. So I figured I'd hit it with that hammered look and it'd be a little more uniform. Looking at the hardware for this, look at the length of these bolts. I'm not gonna be able to install it with this hardware, so I'm gonna hit it with the famous deck screws. Okay, I'm gonna put a pretty heavy bead of mastic under the flashing. I'm gonna connect it in a big circle so no water can come up from any angle. Okay, now I'm gonna do two rows of staggered in a zigzag pattern, same roofing nails, 1-inch galvy. I think I'm pretty happy with that. I'm gonna put a little bead of mastic above each one of the nails, just to make sure nothing penetrates through that. We'll wrap this up. And that is our 5-gang egg box. I'll put the floor and lay out the dividers when we do the interior episode. This will wrap up the exterior part of this egg box. Stay tuned for the next episodes. We're going to be putting on the trim on the outside. We're going to be doing the barn doors, the storage, and the interior. Thanks for sticking with me. Let's always remember to practice kindness. Let's practice compassion and practice humility. Thanks for being with me to help me practice the art of doing. Great videos over here that you might like. Click here to subscribe.